songs that I sing all day long come from? Where do the tunes that I can't help but hum come from? Who makes the music that makes you want to pat your feet? Just give the dues to Music City, home of that Tennessee beat. Who makes the rhymes that my dance makes the jukebox say? Who makes the platters that I'd rather hear the DJ play? Well, you better write a letter just to make your letter complete. Address your mail to Music City, home of that Tennessee beat. Every pretty ballad is a sentimental ballad, the story of a love gone cold. With the guitar pounding and the singer sounding like a sinner who has lost his soul. Where is the city where all the pretty ditties are made? Where is that town where the Nashville sound is played? It's a certain southern city where rickety-tick is obsolete. You'll lose your blues in Music City, home of that Tennessee beat.
Walking horse of yours. He's a proud sight. You got yourself a champion there.
It's about time, Larry. I poured a lot of money into that baby. Hopes, too.
Yeah.
So you hadn't seen Jim around anywhere, have you?
No, not yet.
You'd think he'd have got here, especially today.
Oh, he'll be here. He must have been in a hurry to get somewhere the way he raced down my driveway after he picked up Bill.
Well, if he was racing to get anywhere, you can bet it wasn't any old horse show. Now, if it was a music show, that's another thing. Come in, that darn guitar.
Mr. Burchill?
Yes, Sheriff.
Got your boy in jail down there. Your niece, too, Mr. Schofield. Picked them up outside Mapleton.
Oh, no. In trouble again?
Afraid so. Sideswiped a car. The other driver's hurt. They'd been drinking, and we had to book them. But seeing how they're your kids, the judge set the bail kind of low.
Promised myself last time, no more. As far as I'm concerned, you can keep them there.
I'd like to do the same with that lease of mine, Dan, but you know we can't.
Here's the decision, folks. It's unanimous. The Dalton County Trophy goes to Warrior Lad. Where's Dan Birdsall? Come on up here and get your trophy, Dan.
Go ahead. Let me handle this. I'll go pick him up and drop Jim back off at the farm. You're not going to leave me at this stable. You're going to take me to the house.
I bailed you out. Ain't that enough?
Now, that was mighty nice of you, Mr. Schofield.
I done it for your dad, boy, not you. I got a lot of respect for Dan Birdsell.
Yeah. A lot of respect for his account at your bank, huh?
Think more of it than you do of me.
Now, you shouldn't talk that way, Angel.
Didn't see you come running after me so fast.
I tell you what. You go get your car and come back to me, and we'll go out to the club and share up a little action.
Now, that's more like it. I'll pick up my car and be out as soon as I can, Jim Burt.
Hey, Bill. Get back in this car. bailing me out, Mr. Schofield. Remind me to return the favor someday. Hey, Dad, wait for me. Don't worry, lad, want it, huh?
You give a hoot?
Why not? Sure.
Not even enough to come out to the show.
Well, I've gotten a little straight, but this one wasn't my fault.
Just like the last time, and the time before.
It's the gospel.
Leave gospel out of it.
They can pick on me because I'm Dan Burstall's son.
The police, the courts, they all pick on you. You know where I just was? Put the call through to Mapleton.
How's his leg, you see?
Not the car. Sort of wrecked it up, but a few hundred will cover.
About a man in the hospital.
How's he doing?
Not as bad as he looked. Thank God.
At least he can't sue for much.
Is that all you really care about?
Well, it's his own fault. He shouldn't have just stood there when the light changed.
Everybody in the world should get out of your way. Is that how it is? I guess I never saw you so clear, Jim.
Oh, look, Dad.
Okay, I'll carry one end of the blame. After your mother passed on, I tried to give you everything. Of course, you was all the family left. But it's past blaming now.
But if I promise, it'll be
no. You've promised and pretty talked to yourself from one scrape to another. The fact that I can't keep here to myself no more. The boy I raised is a good-for-nothing bum.
Well, maybe I'm good for something.
Name it.
Well, everybody says I'm pretty good at playing this guitar.
And consider yourself lucky, boy, because that's all you've got to your name now.
What do you mean?
I mean, I'm giving you the last thing I can. Your walking papers.
You mean you're kicking me out?
No, on your own. Like me, when I was a green kid right down from the mountain. It's the only way you'll ever learn what life's all about.
But how will I live?
Find a way, or die.
Okay, if that's what you want, okay. I'll take my clothes and my car and I'll leave.
Your car?
I bought this car.
No car for you to go out and kill someone, nothing. Now take what's on your back and clear off.
Oh, I get it. Kicking out your own failure as a father. Big shot thoroughbred raiser who couldn't even raise his own son.
I've got no son.
And I've got no father. Just a hillbilly on horseback who thinks his money can make me jump.
Get, boy, before you rile me up. I don't want you here when I get back.
You think I can't make it? I'll show you. I'll show you.
I'd like to see Bill, Mr. Schofield.
Well, she's not home.
The car's in the driveway.
That girl's caused enough trouble for his family already. Now, I don't want to see you around here anymore. Is that clear?
Everybody thinks they can push me around.
You're in enough trouble already, young fella. Now, you get your hand off of that door. I'll call the police.
Dog.
Hey, Belle, I'm looking for you.
Uncle Larry says I'm not supposed to see you. It's a federal offense. Uh-uh. You're not supposed to see me either. I'm sunbathing, you nasty man.
My dad's kicked me out of the house.
I heard. Word gets around fast.
Let's go someplace. I've got to talk.
Where? Not now. Your credit in town isn't worth a glass of chump beer.
Who cares? I'm going to blow this place anyway. I'm going to show them all.
Where you figure to go?
Oh, Nashville first. Do a little guitar playing there until I decide what I want. Only problem is how I get to Nashville. Yeah. I haven't got a cent in my pocket.
Neither do I. They took away my allowance. But, I know where you can get plenty.
Where?
Uncle Larry's desk. There's a box. He always keeps a couple hundred dollars in it. I've seen it. It's right through that screen door.
You mean for me to...
Well, I thought of doing it myself.
I couldn't do that. He finds it gone now, he'd know it was me.
He couldn't prove it. The money's got Andy Jackson's picture on it, not his. Anyway, by then, you'd be in Nashville.
I couldn't do that. All I need now is a robbery rap. And...
All right. I was just trying to help. But if you're chicken...
Who's chicken? I just don't want to get in trouble.
Get in trouble? You made it, Jim boy. Well, I guess you just won't make Nashville. Maybe you could talk Uncle Larry into giving you a job. Say he's a delivery boy.
Trouble. It's Mr. Schofield. We had a fight and I hit him with something.
Is he hurt bad?
I don't know. He thought his head was bleeding. He'll listen to you. You've got to call and stop him before he calls in the sheriff.
Where are you going?
To call the sheriff.
You don't understand. I need his money and he caught me going through his desk.
Top of everything else. Now you're a thief.
He'll send me to prison.
Maybe that's where you belong.
Please! I'm your son!
Long gone by now. You know, Uncle Larry got every cop out looking for you.
You think I don't know it? I've been hiding out down by the river all day and all night, without food or anything. You knew where I would be. Why didn't you come looking for me?
I had a date with my friend.
But I've got stolen this now to stake us. $240. You've got to help me. Everyone's against me. My own pa. You've got to come with me.
Well, I'd like to, but I'm off.
Look, there's one thing you better not forget. You helped me get into this trouble, and you're going to help me get out.
All right, Jim boy, all right. Don't get so excited. Now, you know that I'm with you. All the way. All right?
Okay, start the car and let's get out of here.
Have you got your guitar?
I left it in the bushes in case someone recognized me, but... Nashville, here we come.
What's the matter, pal? Get stood up?
Yeah, I got stood up.
You look lower than a snake's belly. Come on. We'll give you a lift.
No. Not unless you're going to Nashville. Once I get there, I'll be all right.
You're in luck, pal. Nashville's just where we're headed.
You are?
Sure. Hop in.
Wait, let me go get my guitar.
Hey, this one's feisty. Needs tenderizing.
What is this?
It ain't Nashville, pal. Figure you'll have to settle for halfway.
Better leave me alone if you know what's good for you.
Ain't collected the fare yet. $240.
Here, take it. I didn't want it anyhow. Just give me my guitar.
Hey, Ike. The man wants his guitar.
Washing his face in the pond. You got any feeling about him?
Voice deep down is telling me this boy's in trouble, Opal.
Nope. My deep down voice is telling me you were still hungry, Matt.
That's right. He's hungry, too.
Hi there. Nice day, ain't it? Yeah, you're right. Miserable hot. Say, my sister over there says you're hungry. You care to join us for a bite?
No, I don't.
Oh, of course, now it ain't much. Just some golden fried chicken, little honey biscuits, butter dripping yam and black eye peas.
I'm not hungry. And I don't need charity, mister.
Cherry cobbler and peach ice cream. A little watermelon thrown in. Come on, boy. Bring your appetite.
You sick yourself. Food's coming right up.
This is my sister, Opal Nelson. I'm Matt. You know, I'm going to feel a mite weak-minded calling you hi there all the time. You got a name tucked someplace inside your clothes?
Jim. Jim Cooper.
Cooper, huh? Now, we know a Cooper. Guitar player named Wally Cooper. He's got his own TV show. You in a relation?
No relation.
Well, glad to hear it. Wally plays the fancy guitar, but he sings like a hog collar with a powerful head cold. Just listening to him will plug up all 8 of your sinus cavities.
Oh, come on, Matt. You're pure jealous. Here you are.
Hey, you're welcome.
You from around here, Jim?
No.
You look kind of bunged up. What happened to you?
I was walking and I fell.
Yeah, ran some knuckle. Where you headed?
Nashville.
That's a mighty long-legged walk, Pilgrim. We'll give you a ride in. You don't mind to stop at the Davidson Theater. Got to stop and say hello to a fellow doing a play date there. Yeah, that's right. We're country music folk. Now, Opal's got the talent, and I got the guitar. Except, I can't play it so good anymore since an accident of mine. How old are you? Got a couple of your records. Well, bless your little record-buying soul, Jim.
They're old ones.
Yeah, I was afraid you'd say that. Things ain't been too plush for us the last few years. Ain't been in the charts for quite some time.
We'll make it again, Matt.
Oh, I ain't complaining. Country music's been mighty good to us. It will be again, as soon as I get up to snuff on some other instruments. Well, we better get a move on if we're gonna make it to Nashville.
Jim, don't you
want
to
go backstage?
No.
Up to you. Why don't you wait here in the car, then? I'll be right back. Can't stay too long.
You can't go in there, fella. Show is on.
Come to see Wally Cooper.
Wait here. I'll get him for you.
Well, if it ain't a sweet singer from Skunk Hollow.
Well, bless me another polecat.
Long time no see, Matt. You look great for a 100-year-old tree stump.
Well, you too, Ollie. You're still solid as an oak. Poison oak. How goes it with the git fiddler? You tore that thing up yet?
Just fixing it. Hey, Opal.
Wally?
How's a gal so pretty come to have a brother so darned ugly?
Well, now, she can't have everything. Anyway, one say to you makes her feel a whole lot better about me.
Well, here we go again, that great Nelson Cooper feud.
Say, you know, we picked up a kid on the road named Cooper. Of course, he's too good looking to be any kin of yours.
Greek folks that helped you, Pilgrim.
Oh, I had to do it. I'm broken. I'm alone.
Yeah, I can see why, too. Oh, okay. What's the story?
I'm a guitar player. Oh, they busted mine. I had to have one to get a job.
Oh, you're breaking my heart.
Oh, I've got to make it in Nashville. Please, you said you couldn't use yours anymore.
No, there wasn't no invitation to steal it. You just might ask about borrowing it if you wasn't a punk thief.
Matt, let him go.
He says he done it because he needs a guitar playing job. That's a lie, too.
It's not.
Oh, I reckon you're more full of lie than a laundry vat, boy.
Maybe his story's true, Matt.
tape, punk. Show us if it's true, before I turn you over.
Matt, he plays good.
With the sweeping, and I could stand some good music. I'm so tired listening to those cowbelling people in that choir of mine. Sometimes I'm almost sorry I got the call.
Well, here, we've got something that might be a little comfort.
Oh, you didn't?
Yep, we did.
Oh, it's them. Oh, now I've got a whole complete collection of him.
Now, don't you go thanking us for that. Ain't all that much. A few beat up old records.
Oh, I'm thanking more than you.
Yeah, I forgot. There's Tom Edison, too.
Oh, you.
Oh, brought some groceries for
you. Oh, thank you.
Oh, and one other thing. A pair of hands to help out around here. Fella here's named Jim Cooper.
He needs a place to stay. I thought you could put him up in the back room.
Why, sure could.
Boy's stony broke. He's a little bit scratchy as a guitar picker and a downright scratch out as a thief. But I figured that maybe you could find something better for him to do than the police corps.
Hello, Jim.
Well, we gotta go.
Oh, you're so sweet.
See you later, sweetheart.
I'm so glad you come by. Now, don't be gone long.
Oh, and just be sure he don't steal any pennies out of your collection.
Oh.
Thanks for nothing.
Don't be frightened. Everybody's welcome here. Where are you from, Jim?
I'm from nowhere.
I've heard tell of it. Mighty big place. Lots of coming and going there. Well, there's a nice stew cooking in the kitchen and some hot tea brewing. Soon as we finish the sweeping in here. When the sisters, a little flat in the refrain, but sharp in the spirit, and that's what God wants to hear. He's got enough heavenly voices up there singing like angels. Well, to carry on now with our musical rejoicing, I'd like to try out a number from a new hymn album. While I was praying, somebody touched me. While I was praying, somebody touched me. While I was praying, somebody touched me. It must have been the hand of the Lord. While I was singing, somebody touched me. While I was singing, somebody touched me. While I was singing, somebody touched me. It must have been the hand of the Lord. And now, brothers and sisters, we have a boy here, new boy, Jim Cooper, that's a new lad staying here at the Tabernacle. He's a poor lost sheep, just like you and me. And now, Jim Cooper, come up here and do something for these folks. Oh, come on, Jim. I hear tell you can really make this guitar talk.
Not me. I don't want to.
Well, I ain't gonna let you shy away now. These folks want to hear you.
No deal, no dice.
Jim, you come in and take this guitar before I bring it over there to you. That's the boy. Now then, let's have something nice and spiritual.
Sure thing, Rev.
My baby gives me love and loving every morning. Well, she gives me lots more loving than I do. I'll go right back to Lord tonight at loving. I'm real stout. Well, I kindled up her flame of love and I'm not gonna let it go out.
That is mighty spirited, Jim. And now, brothers and sisters, let's pray for this boy. Let's pray that he'll find some way to use this talent that God gave him and that his folks will be proud of him.
I don't have any folks, so I don't need your praying. I don't need pity from your bunch of lost sheep.
Wrong song in the wrong place, but still pretty good playing.
You come back to see I didn't steal nothing?
No. I come back as I get thinking about you. You know, I really do believe you have something with a guitar. As raw as Matt says it is.
Nobody can tell me anything about a guitar and my music. I know how good I am. I'm better than any of them.
Pretty cocky for a handout candidate. If you're so good, how come you ain't rich?
Maybe I will be. But not from singing in a church for Reverend Rose.
In case you don't know it, Rose Conley was rated tops in country music before she turned back to religion. And another thing you don't know, some of the biggest stars got their start in churches. Here's where they learned how to put feeling in their songs.
Yes, sir, I bet. In a dump just like this.
Okay, Mr. Big Shot, do you think you're ready for some educating?
What kind of educating?
Come on. It won't hurt much.
Is one of my favorite acts. They're a great team. You know, it takes that kind of teamwork in order to make an act a success. Thank you.
where the Hall of Fame is being built, and Matt and I are playing a benefit tomorrow afternoon at the Music City Association outing to raise funds for it.
Drake on the steel guitar. Jim, you think you learned anything?
Maybe a couple of pointers.
I hope so. I didn't take you on this tour just to shoot an evening.
Yeah, I know. I may not be rich, but I ain't stupid.
You see, I'm interested in you because I...
I know why you're interested. Teaching me about country music's not all you're interested in.
And what else am I interested in?
Yes, baby.
Now, wait a minute.
Come on. I knew you weren't good for me from the start.
Well, if you ain't the pure limit. Oh, no. You turkey head, your tail will never get as big as your brass-plated gall. You'd be a star overnight. Sure, I had a reason for showing you around, because me and my brother need a steady guitar man, and I thought you might be bright enough to work into it. But no chance. You'd figure everything was coming to you on a silver serving tray.
I thought that...
Yeah, well, you can go on thinking till they're ice skating down in hell. Now get out of this car and get lost.
Listen, maybe I had you figured wrong.
I haven't heard you figure anything right yet. So why should I be the exception? Now get out!
Jim.
Yeah, it's me.
I hoped you'd come back. Hoped you wasn't too mad with us here.
Me mad at you?
For not being what you needed us to be.
I know it's not you and your people that's wrong. It's me. I want to change, but I don't even know where to begin.
Well, maybe you've already begun. That's the hardest part. Starting for somewhere when you come from nowhere. Jim, I've been thinking about you. There's something I want you to have. This old guitar.
No, ma'am, Reverend, I couldn't take your guitar.
Well, it ain't very fancy, but it's a good old guitar. Mellowed with a lot of playing. But you can pick at it a whole lot better than I ever could. I want you to have it.
No, ma'am, I couldn't take it.
Well, you can't stop now. It's already yours.
No, ma'am. I can't.
Never turn away a gift from the heart, son. That's like turning away the heart itself.
Do. greats, the Statler Brothers. Real fine job, fellas. Now, I have the honor of introducing His Excellency, the Governor of the Sovereign State of Tennessee, Governor Frank Clements.
I want to welcome all of you to this outing sponsored by the Music City Association to raise funds for Nashville's Country Music Hall of Fame. We can all take pride in the fact that our volunteer state of Tennessee, with its many natural beauties, is also endowed with an overwhelming gift of musical talent, to the extent that the rest of the country and the free world refer to it as that Tennessee beat. It is therefore fitting that we should contribute spiritually and materially to a country music hall of fame in order that we can pay homage to those who have brought such great honor to our state and to their own profession. And before we continue with our musical program, I want to thank you each and all for coming here today, and particularly do I want to thank Tom Beasley for permitting us to use his red barn on Old Hickory Lake for this great event.
Thank you, Governor Clement. And now Opal is going to be joined by her brother, Matt Nelson and Wally Cooper, in a rendition of a real old favorite, Cotton Field.
Told me where to find you. I want to apologize for last night.
Oh, forget it.
Please, don't be mad at me, Opal.
I'm not mad. The trouble with me is I can never stay mad long. Look, I'm not mad, Jim, but I am busy.
I know. I've got something for you. It's for you.
Better beat it, boy. In case you didn't know, this is a private outfit.
Don't worry, I'm leaving.
Best news I had today. Why don't you go try making an honest dollar someplace? Give Reverend Rose a break, too.
Wait a minute, Matt. Jim's got something here. He wrote a song.
Full. That'd be too much like real work.
Well, I like it.
I probably snitched it from the storm, though. I don't care what you think, it's for Opal.
Come on. Let's go see if we can try it. Folks, we have a new song for you.
written by Jim Cooper. And Jim's here to sing it for us. Jim?
Number. It is yours, ain't it?
What do you think?
Okay, just checking. Don't get your eyes in an uproar. Like I'm partners in this country and western record company. I want to try the song out myself. Next time I cut one. Except I doubt if I can fit it in.
Forget it. I didn't write it expecting anything.
Well, maybe I'll do it from old buddy Matt Nelson.
Don't do me any favors.
Ain't just a favor. You can use $300, can't you?
Sure, I can use it, but,
make it $400 just for old Matt.
No, you don't, Foxy Grandpa. Don't come that cheap.
What do you mean, cheap? $500 more than this kid seen.
Your jaw's working, but I don't hear any noise, Wally.
I must unplug them jug ears of yours.
Well, you want this boy's song for your company, you got it. With him winging it on a demo.
What are you, his agent?
Well, let's say that I'm his guardian angel. Take it or pass, Wally. There's other record companies in town.
Well, tell you what. For nobody will set it up.
Now you're talking loud and clear, old buddy.
Thanks, partner.
That I'm the one to pay for what I've done, and now the time has come to say I'm sorry. If I repent today, don't smile and walk away. I mean it.
Hello here, Dan. How you feeling today?
Larry, fine. Good to see you.
How's Morty, lad? Any better?
No, the Beth said his leg is broke too bad.
Oh, he'll ain't. He's too. It's a doggone shame. I know how you're depending on that horse.
Well, ever since Jim left, been one thing right after another.
The Lord above knows I'm sincere.
Time we got you to look at some facts. Now, I know how hard you've been hit this year, Dan, with that accident settlement and losing part of the herd and now Warrior Lad. But boy, you got to think about next year. There's Warrior Lad's Colts.
It's funny, ain't it, Larry? Just don't seem to care about next year.
Must be getting good and old, I guess. Old? Ah, come on, Dan. All you need is a good shot of cash to carry you through.
No, I'm pulling out. He said you knew some people in Nashville that was interested in buying a thoroughbred farm.
Now, you're not really thinking of selling.
I'd appreciate if you'd contact those people for me.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
You look pretty good tonight.
Thank you, little and lovely. How about supper? You, me, and a bottle of wine.
Hey, knock out that slob stuff. We've got a lot of work to do.
Like what, slave driver?
Like turning this three-mule team into a trio. We haven't even begun yet.
We've got all the songs learned for Friday's performance, and I'm starved.
Hey, listen, boy. When you sing for the Music City Association, that's a real test. Well, we got a Who Knows rehearsal as fine as an accent.
Yeah, we also got to eat now.
And I've got to go see Reverend Rose. I promised her I'd sing for them tonight. So if you can hold off about an hour, we'll make that supper.
You'll sing for it first. He's hitting the big time fast. Been picked for the Music City Award. Music City Association. Just hope it ain't too fast.
Well, a few months ago, I would have said yes. In letters carved from everlasting love. Not now.
Softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling for you. Watching for you and for me. Jesus is calling, calling, oh sinner, come home.
Oh. Oh, bless you, Jim Cooper. That was a joyful sound.
Better than my first time here.
This time you knocked them dead. We haven't had this crowd jumping like this since that night that hatchet killer come in here and give himself up.
Guess that cuts me down to size.
As much as I hate to, Reverend Rose, I've got to run.
Well, brothers and sisters, Jim does have to leave, but let's show him how much we appreciate what he's done.
Right. It is Jim Birdsall's voice on the record.
Bell Schofield? How'd you get here?
Followed you from the theater. Come on, get in.
What are you doing in Nashville?
Why, looking for you, Jim Bird. Now, don't act so trapped.
Not trapped. I just thought you'd forgot about me for now.
Now, why would I forget about my...
Well, you don't like chicken feed, remember?
But you ain't chicken feed anymore. Must be starting to make yourself some kind of money. Now, you wouldn't know it to look at you.
I'm not making that much. And what I am making, I'm paying out for debts.
Hmm.
How's things at home? How's my father?
Well, I wouldn't know. I've been away a while myself. Family turned me out of the house.
Well, I guess that ain't surprising news.
Is there any other news you'd like to hear about? Like Uncle Larry? Well, he was doing poorly for a while, but he's all right now.
What are you after, Bill?
I just want to share in my Jim Bird success. That's all. I hear you're due to sing at the big country music show. Now, I wouldn't mind sharing in that tape. Sure could use the money right now.
Proceeds of that are all spoke for. They're going to this church's building fund.
A real good cause, Sugar. But so am I. You know, it'd be just terrible if something butchered your career right now. Like if someone told the Dalton police where to find a certain fella they're looking for. I bet I know what you're thinking right now. How you'd like to kill me.
How'd you guess?
Don't think too hard, Doc. I picked me up some new friends. Real tough fellows. And they'd know just what to do if anything happened to little Belle.
I ain't afraid of your friends, and I don't have any money for you. I told you, I'm broke.
It's a shame. But not after the show Friday.
I told you, that's going for this church.
I tell you what. You meet me right here about 6 o'clock Friday, and I'll tell you how much is going to Belle.
Well, don't hold your breath.
I'd keep that date at 6, or a call goes to Dalton at 6:30.
What are you doing here?
Better late than prison, Jim boy. Lucky for you, I decided to check one more time.
I figured you'd have been putting in a call by now.
Well, I had my finger in the dial. But I just couldn't believe that you're the kind to stand a girl up.
Bill, you've got everything, don't you? Beauty, brains, and brass.
And pretty soon a bundle of money. Now, how's that for kicks?
Well, here's your kicker for tonight. You're not getting any money. It ain't gonna work.
Oh, no? Well, if you think you're gonna make that show, you've got another thing.
I got a little bad news for you, baby. I'm not even thinking of making that show. So you'd better scrounge your money from someplace else. Because I'm cutting out of this territory.
I wouldn't like that, Jim boy. You know, me and my friends went to a lot of trouble to find out how much money you get.
Well, I'm real sorry for you and your friends.
Well, tell them.
Not to go to any old show.
Oh, it'd do you good to relax. Give you a chance to think things over. You know, Dan, that's a giveaway prize for your horses and land. I can't let you take that off.
Got to, Larry. It's the only one going.
The work, the love and care you put in on that place.
Well, that's water over the dam.
Oh, where are you going to live?
Doesn't matter. Any place. Further away, the better.
Can't see why you don't just stay in Dalton.
It's too much to remember there.
Let's go in. Let's go.
No, wait. Listen. Wait, Larry. Let's get it over with. Go back and tell them I'll take the offer.
Well, it can't go now, but they'll be there in the morning. I feel like I've hung on too long already. I don't know what I've been waiting for. Some kind of sign, I guess. That'll never come. Well, now, you never know what little sign might be waiting for you just around the corner.
Let's face it, Larry. I've come to the end of the road. Nothing before me except the picture of an old man, all by himself.
What's the matter, Dan?
I was wrong, Larry. I was wrong.
Was you now?
Tickets. What for?
The show.
Want them soon, huh?
Right away, yes, sir.
Let's see. I got a couple of cancellations. Then the second balcony, but they'll cost you $60 a piece.
That's good. All right, we'll take them.
Ah, it's a smart move. Now, these are for 2 weeks from Saturday.
Oh, we mean for tonight.
Tonight?
Sir, wait, wait. We've got to get in.
Mister, this show's been sold out 3 months back.
But this man's son is singing in there.
Yeah, what's his name?
Birdsell. Jim Birdsell.
We ain't got no Birdsells around here, just some birds trying to outfox me.
But it's true, mister. He's going by the name of Cooper.
The tricks you fellas will try to worm your way in.
Sir! Sir, we've got to get in.
If you don't quit rapping on this wound, I'm going to call in the troops.
But, friend, if you ever had a son, listen to me now.
Okay, trio.
Opal and me is going to fight our instincts and step aside for a few minutes. Because we got a young friend with us here that, well, he deserves listening to. A few months back, we met him walking the road to Nashville. He's broke, alone, and, well, a pretty sorry-looking case. Well, he went and wrote himself a song called I'm Sorry. He's come a pretty far piece since then. Folks, meet our partner, Jim Cooper.
I'd like to thank everyone for making it so I can be up here on this stage tonight. Especially you, Opal and Matt Nelson. And a wonderful, wonderful woman who's in the audience tonight. Reverend Rose Conley. I just wish that I deserved everything that you've done for me. But there's something that I just can't keep hid from you anymore. My name's not Cooper. But Birdsell, Jim Birdsell. And I changed it because I'm wanted by the police in my hometown of Dalton for clubbing a man. But tonight, I'm going to face it the best way that I know how.
Sing for us, Jim, please.
Yes, I'd like to sing my song tonight. I'd like to sing it for one man who's here, my father.
I know that I'm the one to
We're all the 30 days.